In the last couple months, we have been overtaken, not overtaken, that's the wrong word, but we have been exposed to, that's a better word, artificial intelligence. This open AI, this chat GPT artificial intelligence. And I, like you, was going in there and I was typing in, like, tell me about this, tell me about this. And then I thought, wait a minute, I'm a memory expert. What does ChatGPT, OpenAI think about memory training and memory improvement? And so that's what we're going to do today. I've had guests on our show before where I interview them and I ask them questions. Can you tell me about this? Can you tell me about this? They give me their opinion and then we discuss it. And I thought, well, why can't I do the same thing? Except why can't my guest be artificial intelligence? I want to interview artificial intelligence. And it, by the way, it's real easy to schedule artificial. You want to, if I want to interview another memory expert, we got to coordinate our schedules and all that. If I want to interview ChatGPT, I just got to open up my laptop and boom, there it is. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the show OpenAI, ChatGPT. Welcome to the show. So happy that you are here, ChatGPT. I want to ask you some questions. And I'm just going to talk about it. I'm going to give you my feedback on your answer. Here's a question that I'm going to type into for you. Is it possible to improve memory? Is it possible to improve memory? Look at this. Look at what it says here. Whoa. Well, first of all, thank you, ChatGPT, for confirming my life's work in your first sentence. Yes, here I'm going to read this now, and then I'm going to give you my. I'm going to go through this and read this, and I'm going to give my reply. It gives us seven bullet points here. I'm going to read each one of these seven bullet points, and then just respond to them. Yes, it is possible to improve memory. Here are a few ways you can improve your memory. Number one, exercise. Exercise has been proven to improve brain function, including memory. It increases blood flow to the brain and helps to promote the growth of new brain cells. This is a great point right here. Exercise and improving your memory. A lot of people overlook it. Did you know that as you age, your hippocampus shrinks? Your hippocampus is responsible for your long-term memory. Think about this. As you age, the part of your brain that is responsible for your long-term memory shrinks. Do you know what one of the only proven ways to stop and maybe even reverse the shrinkage of your hippocampus is? Exercise. Exercise is one of the few things that can stop and reverse the shrinkage of your hippocampus. Also on here, it says our exercise increases blood flow. Now, why is that important? It didn't really go into it here, but think about it for a second. If the blood flow to your brain is improved, what else is getting to your brain? More nutrients, more oxygen. Oxygen wakes up your brain. You ever heard of that ginkgo biloba pill? You take the pill and it helps your memory. Do you know what ginkgo biloba, one of the main things it does? It improves your blood flow. So more oxygen is getting to your brain. Your brain is more alert. You can accomplish the same thing through exercise. So go for a walk, exercise to improve your memory. According to ChatGPT, exercise is number one, and I agree. Let's see what it says for number two. Number two, sleep. Getting enough sleep is important for memory consolidation. During the sleep, the brain processes and organizes information from the day, helping to solidify new memories. So this is great. This is a great point here on sleep and memory. I met a guy named Dr. James Moss about 10 years ago. He wrote a book called Sleep for Success. He actually coached Olympic athletes on their sleep schedule and how to get better sleep so they could perform better in the Olympics. I learned something really, really interesting from Dr. James Moss over 10 years ago. I was in the audience of one of his speeches and I ended up reading his book. He said, you know, you've always heard, and it's important to get enough sleep the night before a test. And that's true. It is. It's important to get enough sleep the night before a test. But he said it's also important to get enough sleep during the learning process. So all the weeks that you're learning or that you're studying something new, it's important to get good night's sleep those nights as well. Why? Well, ChatGPT right here says because during the sleep process, the brain organizes and consolidates the information. Here's what's happening. As you get into that REM level of sleep, your brain starts replaying the memories that you learned during the day. So you are learning information during the day. When you go to sleep that night, when you get into that deepest level of sleep, the REM sleep, your brain will replay what you learned during the day and consolidate and make the information stronger. But if you don't get to that deep REM level of sleep, your brain doesn't replay it. So you wake up knowing the information less if you had bad night's sleep. It's important to get a good night's sleep the day before a test, but it's also important to get a good night's sleep during the learning process, during those weeks. And that's something that ChatGPT just reminded us of. Thank you, artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence, what is your next point on is it possible to improve your memory? It says nutrition, eating a healthy diet that is rich in fruits, vegetables, omega-3 fatty acids can help improve the brain health and memory. Nutrition is also something that's overlooked in memory. I even saw one memory expert going around saying there's no such thing as brain foods. Brain foods don't improve your memory. You just don't know enough. It was a young kid. He was in his 20s, and he was just so full of bravado in himself. Think about it. Your brain is like any other part of your body. The better you treat it through good nutrition and exercise, the better it's going to respond for you. And right here it puts omega-3 fatty acids. I'm going to tell you what I do every single day. I don't get it perfect. I really do not get my nutrition perfect. I mean, I can lose 5-10 pounds almost at all times. But I do as good as I can. Well, maybe I can do better. But you know what I do every day? I take an omega-3 fish oil pill every day for my brain. Omega-3 fish oil pills is wonderful for your brain. I take a multivitamin every day for my brain. I try to drink at least 70, 80 ounces of water every day for my brain. Water is one of the most overlooked, however you want to say it, brain foods. Here's the deal. A dehydrated brain can't focus. Let me say that again. A dehydrated brain can't focus. If you have a dehydrated brain, you're going to have brain fog. You're not going to be able to focus. Drink more water. Take an omega-3. Take a multivitamin. Good nutrition and exercise. Is it possible to improve your memory? Okay. I hope ChatGPT, artificial intelligence, says somewhere in here, take a memory training course. Okay. So let's see what it says. Mental stimulation is number 4. Engage in activities that challenge your brain, such as puzzles, games, or learning a new skill can help improve your memory. You know what? I'm going to do a little bit of a pushback on this. Okay. I don't think there is anything wrong with video games. You know, there's a lot of video games out there, like do this game and it will improve your memory. And then over time, people are like, oh my gosh, yes, I can do the game better now. Well, did you really improve your brain's function, or are you just getting better at the game? You know, sometimes I think some of that stuff is kind of junk. I think you're just getting better at the game. Lawrence Katz wrote a book called Keep Your Brain Alive. And in it, he coined a term called neurobics. And he said, you don't improve your memory or improve your brain function by doing a game, doing the same thing over and over again. He said, you improve your brain function by learning something new or doing something different, driving home a different way. If you're right-handed, write with your left hand. This book, Keep Your Brain Alive, it's an audio. You can get it on Amazon, or maybe I'll put a link down below in the comments. This book says that you engage your brain by doing things that are different, by doing things that are unusual, not the same thing every day. And by the way, I'm not disagreeing with ChatGPT, artificial intelligence. I'm just kind of expanding on this, because in this point, it says learning a new skill, which is what I'm saying, learning something new. I'm just making a point here that there are some games that claim to improve your memory, and I don't know if they do. I think you might just be mastering the game. That's just my opinion on that. But mental stimulation certainly is a key to keeping a healthy brain. There's no doubt about it. They say that people who are prone to get Alzheimer's are people who live in isolation, because they don't have people to talk to all day long, and their brains aren't as stimulated anymore. So mental stimulation is a valid point. I'm not arguing with the artificial intelligence, okay? Just giving my 2 cents and my perspective. Mindfulness practice, meditation, and yoga have been shown to help improve memory, focus, and cognitive function. That's so true. You know, just relaxation techniques, breathing techniques, mindfulness techniques, keeping your brain relaxed. That's one of the biggest keys to your memory. I remember when I would go to the USA Memory Championships, the World Memory Championships, the week before the competition, I would get massages. I would just practice and sit in my room and close my eyes and visualize the tournament. at that point, the week before the tournament, I wasn't worried about my memory anymore. I was worried about one thing: being relaxed, lowering my cortisol levels, being comfortable, being confident, meditating, massages, breathing, relaxation, so my brain could operate. You know, your brain operates so well when it's relaxed. You ever been in the shower and you got a wonderful idea? Or you're getting a massage and you got a wonderful idea? Or you're about to fall asleep at night and you got a wonderful idea? Well, that idea was there the whole time, but it took your brain relaxing for it to surface. Relaxation and mindfulness, yoga, breathing, all that wonderful for improving your memory. Number six, in memory techniques, finally, thank you, ChatGPT, thank you, okay. Techniques such as mnemonics, visualization, and the method of loci, oh yes, booyah, high five artificial intelligence. I am validated, my life's work has been validated, my entire career has been staked on the usefulness of the method of loci. I refer to it often as the memory palace or the mind palace, but the method of loci is the exact same thing. And that's point number six here on improving your memory. Now, artificial intelligence, I would make an argument to you that you should have made this your number one point and not your number six point because you were stressing me out for a minute. I was like, oh my gosh, do I really want to do this video or not? The method of loci is a technique that was developed 2,500 years ago in Greece by a man named Simonides. And Simonides determined that you could remember anything if you visualized it around a room. So here in this room, we've got the Brain Athlete Show logo, we've got the microphone, we've got the coffee cup, and we've got the computer. So now we can remember four words. We see a washing machine up here, so imagine the logo's in a washing machine. We see a dam on the microphone, like a dam on a river, and the dam breaks and washes the microphone away. We see a chef, your favorite chef, Chef Boyardee, he's made a soup here, and you're drinking the soup. You're drinking the chef's soup. And then right here, you got medicine dripping down the back of the laptop. Medicine, pills, NyQuil, Advil, all dripping down here. What were the words? Washing machine, dam, chef, medicine. This is a mind palace. This is the method of loci. You could remember a string of words. I teach students all the time how to memorize the presidents of the United States this way. Washing machine, Washington. A dam, Adams. Chef, Jefferson. Thomas Jefferson. You know Thomas Jefferson? Medicine for Madison. Washing machine, Washington. A dam, Adams. Chef, Jefferson. Medicine, Madison. This is the Mind Palace, the method of loci. By the way, in my Black Belt Memory course, which is a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful memory improvement course, I teach you how to master the Mind Palace, where you can memorize the periodic table of elements, history dates, facts. You want to pass the bar exam, or you want to become a nurse, or you want to become a doctor, or you want to become a pilot. You got all this information to remember. Get the Black Belt Memory course. It's at the link down below. I got a free gift. Enter your email address and get the course. But I'm so glad that it put memory techniques in here and the method of loci. That's huge. Last one, repeat and review. That's the number seven point. Repeat and review the information regularly. This will help you make memory stronger and last longer. Guys, that's so crucial. That is so crucial. One of the most overlooked aspects of memory is review. I hear it all the time. People say to me all the time, Ron, I learned something 2 weeks ago and I can't tell you what I learned. My memory is so bad. Well, have you reviewed it the last 2 weeks? No, but I can't remember it. Well, you can't remember because you didn't review it. Review is a crucial step in the memory process. If you're not reviewing it, you're not going to remember. Study something today, review it tomorrow, then learn new information. Then on day three, review what you learned on day one and day two, and then do day three. On day four, review what you learned on day one, day two, and day three, and then add new information on day four. Always review what you learned before. If you don't, you're not going to be able to remember anything. So today, our guest was ChatGPT, artificial intelligence, and the question I asked it is it possible to improve the memory? And it gave us the answers. Exercise, sleep, nutrition, mental stimulation, mindfulness, memory techniques. And if you want to learn my memory techniques, click the link down below, get my Black Belt memory course, just enter your email address, you're going to love it. And repeat and review. Then the artificial intelligence goes on to say, it is important to note that some memory loss is a normal part of aging. That's true. However, engaging in these activities and avoiding risk factors such as exercise, cutting alcohol consumption, and smoking can help maintain cognitive function. You know what? One of the things that's why smoking is one of the things that's so bad for your memory, it constricts your blood vessels. That blood flow is not getting to your brain as effectively. Smoking is horrible for your brain and your memory. Alcohol consumption, I haven't had a drink of alcohol in over 3 years. I did not only do it for memory, that's part of it, but there are other things, you know. As a man ages, I'm getting ready to be over 50. The more alcohol I drink, the weaker my muscles become. You can drink in moderation if you want. I eat too much sugar, so I'm not like the picture of health here, but I'm just telling you what I am reading on ChatGPT. If you want to get my memory course, click the link down below. By the way, give me a like if you liked what my guest today. If you appreciated my guest, ChatGPT, give me a like, comment, subscribe. I will teach you how to improve your memory and your mind on the Brain Athlete Show, but you must subscribe. Click that subscribe button.